Yosh, fellow gamers, we are we're tearing it up on Doug Dimmadome sells propane, and so last episode I actually forget what happened. Oh yeah, we're on the bath for some reason. Hero slid a note under my door, but it was really Kyoko who wanted us all to meet here because we have something to talk about. Taka is an absolute mad lad. He's insane. You see him in the middle there. He's like fused. He's like a fusion of Mondo and Kiyotaka. So that's great. Byakuya still wants to kill everybody. We did our first save scum last time when we gave Kyoko the wrong present, and even this present she was like didn't love it. We've been killing it with Celeste. We've been giving her all the presents that she fucking wants. So, you know, Keska fuck with that. But anyway, let's do it. Let's get back into it. As soon as I got to the dressing room, an angry voice echoed out,
"F you!"
This isn't a PG game, is it? "Hey, you! How long were you gonna keep us waiting?" Taka's irritated voice pierced the air as he stared pointedly at his wristwatch. "It's almost 10 o'clock, you know that? Bedtime for all the good little boys and girls." Goddamn. I'm gonna adjust my webcam a little bit so you can see more of the fun. Alright. Shut up.
What?
"What did you say? You want to make you cry, you little girl?" Taka, who seems to be even worse off than I'd heard. Ha ha ha. Look at me laugh. Well, maybe it's a good thing. Maybe he's finally starting to grow a personality. "Nani, you got a lot of..." You got a lot of poop falling out of that mouth of yours, you know that? Very quotable. "How rude. A maggot like you has no right to speak that way to our heaven sent sensei."
Oh.
"Are you back to your normal gloomy self? I can hardly keep track at this point." Shut up.
Hey, come on.
"Well, anyway, everyone's here, right? Then my messenger duty is complete."
"Hey.
You want us all to meet here, right, Kyoko? So what are we doing here?"
"How about that?"
"Isn't it obvious? It's gotta have something to do with Alter Ego, right?"
"That's right."
"Yeah, totally. Did he finally find a clue? What is it? A way out? The mastermind's true identity?" "Have you guys ever heard of this website called Iken Has Cheeseburger?" Okay, she's not fucking saying anything. What do you have to think about this?
"You're such a jerk."
"What do you have to say about this, Kiyotaka?"
"Like I said, it's almost 10. Hurry up and spill it."
Kiyokidoke. "I should probably ask Kyoko what's going on before anything else." "Well, I just wanted to see. I just wanted to fucking see it." That's not good. Gone? She said it's gone. I didn't read that out. "I came here a little earlier to check up on things, and that's when I discovered Alter Ego, the laptop, and Waffle Brand has disappeared."
"Nani?"
"No way!"
"You're JKing, correct? ...
Oh,
What? She's gone? He, bitch. He's gone.
F you!
You can't be fudging serious. What do you do with him?"
"Was it the mastermind? Did they finally notice what we were up to?" "I told Alter Ego to yell if anyone he didn't recognize appeared. If it was the mastermind, I'm sure he would have alerted us. Maybe we just missed it?"
"However,
I was in the laundry room right next door all day. There's no way I wouldn't have heard it. But if it wasn't the mastermind, then it was some of us." Nice delivery, you fuck. "The solution to this particular mystery is obvious. It could only have been
him."
"Without a doubt. Mr. Ishimaru, you stole her, didn't you?" "Nani, I'm the ultimate moral compass. I would never do something like that."
"I don't think it counts what you say about yourself like that." That's actually, you know what, Aoi?
Aoi
Asahina, you're right on the money. You're the suspicious one here. You're nothing but a big jiggling sack of fat. Oh, okay, she's talking about Hifumi. I thought you were talking about Aoi, and I was like, they're really taking pot shots at her. "Shows what you know. This is my true form. I still have 3 more transformations left."
"Damnation!"
"Wait, I mean, it wasn't me. Everyone knows you're the thief." Wait, is that... Did he actually just shows what you know? You're the special one here. You're not but a big... Oh, okay.
"Wrong, it's
you."
"Serious?"
"Well, I'm sure it was one of you. So whoever did it, just hurry up and
wrong.
Confess. No, there's no way either one of them did it."
"Huh?"
"Hmm?"
"So...
I told Alter Ego to yell if either Taka or Fume came into the dressing room."
"What?"
"Nani.
Whew.
It was a countermeasure against the clear danger that one of them might come for it. But I never heard any yell.
So you were waiting as well?
Indeed.
Exactly, which means it was not them.
But...
then who the fuck was it?
So that's it.
The fundamental circumstances are becoming clear. I'm not following this. I haven't been focusing on what they've been saying as much, because I'm just kind of like, oh, maybe no one will murder this time. Definitely someone is going to murder. They would not have tutorials that long for the trials if there's not going to be another murder.
If it wasn't the mastermind and it wasn't Taka Hirofumi, then quite simply, it was someone else. Makoto, Celeste, Sakura, Hina, Toko, or myself. One of us must be the thief.
Would Kyoko have a reason to steal it? So we know it wasn't Taka Hirofumi. Kyoko... I mean, maybe. Maybe she has some motive. I just don't know. I like Kyoko, but you can't trust a bitch in this fucking school.
That's terrible!
Why would any of us, why would any of the United States want to steal Alter Ego? How about this for a reason? There is a traitor among us.
Epic! Epic!
It's an Among Us reference, everybody. It's an Among Us reference. Don't you fucking get it? Oh, shit. Whatever. I fucked it up. Huh? Let's go back to Bobus. One of us is working for the mastermind. A spy. Kyoko? It's gotta be Kyoko. She's the most sus, dude. She's like the most sus. You think she's like this cool mystery girl. Really, she's the villain. Fuck, man. It's like Sayaka all over again. I mean, if Makoto's like, I trust what's her nuts 110%, I'm gonna be like, bitch, that's it. And that's the one who stole Alter Ego. Can you deny the possibility? It can't be. I've actually been thinking for some time now I've actually been thinking for some time now that there might actually be a spy among us. The mastermind brought someone in to help keep things moving smoothly. A spy for the mastermind? Imposter?
No. C'est impossible.
Something that horrible. There's no way. Why do you not speak? Are you struck silent by your inability to comprehend such a possibility?
Say what?
I don't care.
I don't care who, someone, anyone, save her.
Please, rescue her. I'm begging ya. I just want to see her smiling face again.
Damn it.
Oh, he's crying. He's flame crying. God damn, look at that.
Same here. How many times do they have to kill bro before they're happy?
Bro.
I'll beg. I'll scrape my head across the ground. Just please give him back.
So,
this is pretty messed up, but... still, I think I kind of get how they feel.
At the very least.
I think Alter Ego is most likely still safe, for the moment at least.
Yes, indeed.
If they wanted to destroy it, they wouldn't have taken it. They would have done it right here.
I see.
So you're saying whoever did it has something else in mind for them. I mean, if they wanted to destroy it too, they could just... because that like would throw suspicion at everybody.
It'd be like someone stole it.
And they maybe... but, I mean, they could have just destroyed it and that would probably do the same thing. Something else.
Damn it!
That doesn't matter. Nothing. Nothing else matters. No matter what it takes, I'm gonna get it back!
That's my promise as a man.
I swear it! I will save her!
Using the power of love. It's nighttime, hoes. Don't go in the dining hall. I wanna see. I'll watch these, because maybe he says something different. Probably not.
Announcement. It is now 10 p.m.
Oh, it is. That's right. Put on auto.
As such, it is officially nighttime.
Go to
bed,
sleepyhead.
Soon the doors to the dining hall will be locked, and entry at that point is strictly prohibited.
You got it.
Okay, then. Sweet dreams, everyone. Good night. Sleep tight. Don't let the bed bugs bite.
Don't let those nasty bugs bite you on the bum. Owie, it's nighttime.
There is nothing to be done.
It is unfortunate, but we will have to leave the search for tomorrow. For now, everyone get some sleep. Trust you, Celeste.
How could you be so casual? We don't have time to wait around.
What good are you if you are too tired? You will be much more effective after a good night's sleep.
Who gives a crap about effective? We're talking about our feelings here.
That's relatable.
Calm down.
Anything we do at night brings a higher chance of the mastermind noticing us. Celeste is right. We should begin our investigation tomorrow morning.
They definitely know that we're fucking meeting in the, like, we're having a bath.
What do you think, Makoto? I agree with you. If we run around tonight in a panic, the mastermind is sure to notice and we won't get anything done. Taka, Hifumi, I know how you feel right now, but it's best if, just for tonight, you can try to endure it.
My teacher in university, I went to acting university, and this guy is like, he's like big into like Stanislavski kind of like method acting, that kind of stuff. And he would always, he was like, word pronunciation was the, like, one of the most important things for him. Like, he actually, he called someone out like a full note, and it wasn't just like fix that. It was like, he explained why they were wrong. Cause there's in Canada, we have a, it's, I don't know what the equivalent would be in the state. It's like the I guess a governor. So like the governor for a whole state. In Canada, we would call them a premier. And someone said like, oh, I'm the premier of Ontario or something. And he actually like later was like, it's premier. Premier is the start of a show and blah, blah, blah. And he would go, he was like that specific about stuff. And I'll always remember him saying, it was like, you don't say endure, it's endure. And there was another word, but I can't remember what it was. But every time I see it, that reminds me of him. Anyway.
This is fine.
Okay, then let us part for today. We will begin our search for Alter Ego in the morning.
And you should think about what I said. Someone may very well be spying for the mastermind.
... Makoto Neagi is kind of scared. Alter Ego, gone as quickly as he appeared. We'd finally discovered some small measure of hope, but even that was taken away from us, and we couldn't even put up a fight. We were given hope, and then when that hope was taken away, despair. It's just like what the mastermind is doing to us. The mastermind took it. Then could it really be true? Whoever stole Alter Ego, could they really be working for the mastermind? If that's true...
No, it can't be! There's no way!
I didn't even realize I yelled that out loud. The scary thing isn't the idea of someone spying on us. What's really scary is the idea that we're starting to doubt each other again. That scares me more than anything. Damn it! I threw myself into bed, trying to shake off all those unsettling thoughts. Before long, I fell into a restless sleep. Can we talk about how square that bed is, too? That is like that thing is like a fucking, like, tablet. Murder is a word whose definition changes with time, with place, with society. If murder is evidence of abnormality, then all of history's greatest heroes must have been abnormal.
Sometimes the murders that people forgive are way more abnormal than the ones they don't.
Yeah, man. Brother. So philosophical. Holy shit. Ding dong, bing fucking bong.
Good morning, everyone.
All right, it's a beautiful day. Today,
we have to look for Alter Ego.
Okay, first things first, to the dining hall. Watch Alter Ego be right there. I found myself in surprisingly high spirits and hurried to the dining hall. But when I found out what was waiting there for me... Ooh, never mind. Quite the opposite. Is this it? What happened to the others? Aren't they coming? Oof. There were only three people in the dining hall. Sakura, Hina, and Kyoko. So including me, only four people? God, this is why I hate people who take their sweet time with everything. Anyway, let's wait a little longer for the others. So we decided to wait in case anyone else showed up. But no matter how long we waited. So... It's 8:00. We've been waiting here a full hour. Fuck, why haven't the others come? Hiro and Celeste have never missed a day till now. And what I'm really worried about is Hifumi and Taka. They were more eager than anyone to look for Alter Ego, and they're not here.
It can't be.
Something must have happened. Shit. Don't fucking die. As an actor now? That's a good question. Which do I like? Probably, I don't know. I'd say, like Brecht I like Brechtian. Pretty good. I like that kind of stuff. I had to write an essay in university, and I was trying to fucking, like, finagle it so that I could write the title as Eggs for Breakfast.
It would seem...
Huh? I was careless. I was too distracted by alter ego. But Monokuma gave us a motive. There was no way something wouldn't happen eventually. Monokuma's motive.
$10 million!
$10 million fat bucks.
I've prepared this graduation present for whichever lucky student makes it out of here alive.
Nice,
what
okay,
do you
great.
Think? It's $10 million! 10 million smackaroos!
Nice.
It's like totally wowy, wow, wow, am I right?
Yeah, you certainly are. Don't tell me someone did something for money! That's what I wanted to say, but I didn't bother. I already understood. I understood that I hated that I did. You can never really know another person completely. Anything can happen here, and you can't consider it strange. Not really.
Hey.
We need to go look for the people who never showed up. Oh, okay, let's go track them down. Without another word, we left the dining hall.
Hey.
A captivating title. You want to start your day off right. A couple eggs. What about you? What side of the fence would you be on in that debate? We can cover more ground if we split up. Sakura, you go check the dorms. Make sure to check all of our rooms. Makoto, you check the first floor of the school. Meanwhile, I'll check the second floor. Sakura's checking the rooms. I'm checking the first floor. She's checking the second floor.
Okay,
then I guess I'll check the third floor.
Anyway.
Don't take any risks. If anything happens, I'll call for help right away. I really hope nothing happens. Yeah, I'm actually hoping something does. I want you to fucking die. Just kidding. I love Aoi. Okay, let's go. Anxiety was written across each of our faces as we went our separate ways. Without hesitating, I rushed to the first floor of the school. All right, Beesh. Okay, I need to look around the first floor. Do I, though? Who is your waifu in this game? Well, I've been avoiding... I technically none of them, because I don't think any of them are legal age in the country that I am in. So I can't say. I can say who my favorite character is. It would have to be like Aoi or maybe or Kyoko. I really fucking like Kyoko. It's probably Kyoko, honestly. But I just don't trust her. What about you? Who would you say? Oh, right. I'm supposed to be looking around. I got fucking super distracted. Does it actually tell me where the exclamation point is? It does not. I'm going to guess it'd be like in the gym or something. But, this blackboard belongs to us now. Secret beauty. Wow. Let's check it out. Even now, the mastermind is probably on the other side of the surveillance camera. Just thinking about it puts me on edge, but there's nothing I can really do about it. Well, I don't see nothing here, except maybe coins. That would be nice to get. Let's just skip past it. I want some coins. I want some fucking coins. That's the same thing. It's not much point in worrying about it now. I should try to just forget about it. All right, well, that was efficient. That was an efficient and big search. She's goddamn big. She's big fucking brain. Ultimate big brain, I think. I think, honestly, my theory, Kyoko, ultimate big brain. That's what I would say. That's what I would fucking say. It's just a mystery, right? Like, mystery is always kind of like, you're always kind of interested in the most mysterious. I find him most interested in the most mysterious character. That's where a window would be, but there's some kind of huge fucking metal thing there. And I just want a coin, but I don't think it's going to give it to me. It's probably just like, hey, head out, find the, Holy fuck, that scared the absolute dick out of me. Nani? That was Hina! She's supposed to be checking. The third floor! The coins, you can spend them in the mono machine, and they'll, depending on how many coins, so pretty much you put a coin in the machine, and it'll give you like a random item that you can give to someone as a present, but, the more you use the machine, the higher the percentage that you'll get a repeat also goes up. Right now I'm at like 30% chance of a repeat if I just put one coin in. So, but the more coins you put in, the more it brings down that percentage. So essentially you get them for completing chapters and for just looking around the rooms. And like it helps sometimes, because honestly having like maybe one extra coin to bring that percentage down just by like 1%, it's nice. Scared the dick out of you. It certainly did. There's no time to think. I was running for the stairs before I knew what was happening. There she is. She's a fucking corpse. Right away, I saw her standing there in the hallway.
Please!
Makoto. I don't know where it went. Popped right off. Makoto! Hina! Nani is wrong. It's awful. The rec room. It was only ever Celeste and fucking... Oh, Celeste dead? And when I looked inside, I saw... What did you see? I better go get the others, right? I'm going to go get him. You go on ahead, Makoto. You go on in there and fucking... You deal with that trauma, boy. Before I could say anything, she was rushing downstairs. The rec room? What did she see in there? By this point, I was used to acting without thinking. So without thinking... I left into the rec room. Okay. It's just funny. First thing I saw when I got in the rec room was... Oh, fuck. Oh, shit. He certainly is. He certainly is. It was Celeste, and she was hurt. It was Callus. First things first, Celeste. I gotta look around the room and check for coins. I don't have time to think about couches. It's true, honestly. All right, let's talk to her. How you doing, girl? Makoto. Celeste. What happened? I was stupid. I got attacked. Attacked. By who? Actually, by whom? I guess it could be... I think it would be by whom. I am not sure. Some sort of strange man. Strange man? A suspicious person whose existence is so unusual, I can't help but call him strange. Okay. That's right. Money, man. Money overall. $10 million. That's what's at stake here. Without a doubt, it was some sort of strange, suspicious individual. And that man attacked me with the hammer on the ground there. On the ground there. Let's first of all take a look. A dartboard. I don't have time to think about this. Ah, God, stupid. The fuck is that? What is this? Justice hammer? It's some kind of wooden hammer or something. Pretty strange design. Mystery man. That's my... Mystery man is my waifu. There's some writing on the head. Justice Hammer 1. Or Justice 1 Hammer. It's a strange middle name. That is the hammer he attacked me with. I barely managed to avoid the blow, but I stumbled and fell. And now I now curse my lack of daily exercise. Lack of daily... I thought you go for walks every night. Noted. Duly fucking noted. So you were attacked with this. Justice Hammer 1. Makoto, Celeste.
Okay.
There she is. I found Sakura. What? Celeste, what on earth happened here? Apparently she was attacked by some kind of strange man. That emote. Oh no, a strange man. Tell us everything you can remember, Celeste. Be as detailed as you can. Well, it all happened early this morning. I woke up a little bit before 7 a.m., had my nighttime shit, and it was not over yet. But I knew it was about to end, so I decided it would be okay if I decided to take a little stroll around the first floor. Is that right? I understand now. That was a mistake. Anyway, that is where I first saw the strange man. I was immediately wary of him. Who do you think is the culprit? I don't fucking know. I think OB Tankman 58 is the culprit, honestly. He's doing it for the primes. Anyway, that is where I first saw the strange man. I was immediately wary of him. He was obviously sus, so I just decided to follow him in secret. I have no idea who could be right now. As I followed, I saw him go into the rec room. I tried to peek through the gap in the door, which is when he noticed me, and that's when you were attacked. It happened after 7 a.m., just after nighttime had ended. Okay. I'm gonna... You know, let's go... I gotta go back. I'm gonna go back up. I got attacked. Attacked by who? I'm not sure. Some sort of strange man. Strange man. A suspicious person. Is so unusual. I can't help but call him strange. Without a doubt. Some sort of strange, suspicious individual. And that man attacked with the hammer on the ground there. A dartboard. Makoto's first thought. A dartboard. I don't have time to think about this.
What is this? It's some kind of wooden hammer, something pretty strange design, something Justice Hammer 1. That is the hammer he attacked me with. I barely managed to avoid the blow, but I stumbled and fell. I now can't curse my lack of daily exercise. That's a fucking lie. You're in good shape because you're walking all the time. So you were attacked with this, Justice Hammer 1. Makoto, Celeste, I found Sakura. So Celeste, what happened here? Apparently she's attacked by some kind of strange man. A strange man. So that's everything you remember, Celeste. Be as detailed as you can. Okay, she woke up a little before 7. And she left. If I say the little first floor. I understand now that was a mistake. That's not necessarily out of character for her. But she uses it as nighttime, which is strange. I understand now that was a mistake. Anyway, that is where I first saw the strange man. I was immediately wary of him. He was obviously sus, so I decided to follow him in secret. As I followed him, I saw him go into the rec room. Which is where he noticed me. That's when you were attacked. How does she know he's a strange man? I don't know. I guess maybe you could tell he's a guy. Yeah, I feel like you could tell if you're looking at someone. Depending on what they're wearing, you could tell. It happened after 7 a.m., just after nighttime had ended. If he's wearing like a big trench coat or something, maybe it'd be harder, but that's fair. That's not a bad point. It happened after 7 a.m., just after nighttime had ended. So if it happened just after 7 o'clock, then that was just about an hour ago, right when we were all meeting in the dining hall. That attack caused me to lose consciousness, which would mean I was unconscious for about an hour. Well, I'm just glad you weren't hurt too badly. That is because I begged and groveled for my life. Sakura's like, yeah, you did.
As for me,
I told him I would do anything if he spared me. Oh, she's feeling greater now. I offered to lick his boots, whatever it took.
I see.
So you were willing to throw away all your pride. Shut the fuck up, Sakura. Well, I don't know. Die with honor, I guess. But also, fuck that. It is a necessary skill for survival. Anyway, the important thing now is that we go search for the suspicious individual. If we do not hurry, this could become a serious problem.
Reaction!
Celeste, what do you mean a serious problem? Well, I don't know. There's some kind of strange man walking around the fucking halls with obvious violent intent. So maybe that's a serious problem. When I looked in the rec room, I saw that the suspicious man was not alone. He had with him Hifumi. Celeste sus. Yeah, a little bit, because she had, like, they knock her out and then she just begs for her life and they're like, ah, okay, sounds good. You totally saw me and you probably know who I am. After he attacked me, he dragged Hifumi away.
What?
You mean Hifumi was kidnapped? Shouldn't we start looking for him then? Listen, Celeste, did anything in particular stand out about this strange guy? Also, where the fuck is Kyoko? She's on the second floor. Sakura was checking out the dorms. So Hina definitely, if I heard her on the first floor, Kyoko definitely would have fucking heard her scream. Where's Taka? I don't know. That seems, the thing about Taka doing it is it seems so obvious. Listen, Celeste, did anything in particular stand out about this strange guy? Did anything stand out? Well, the big fat fucking hammer on my arm did. Rather than trying to explain it, it would probably be faster if I simply showed you. Show us.
Indeed.
This is Hifumi's hand-me-down, his digital camera. You don't mean...
Actually.
I was able to photograph the suspicious individual without him realizing it. To Byaku, yeah, I didn't even think about that. Seriously? Let's see it. I would tell you not to be shocked, but I fear it would do you no good. With that strange comment in mind, we all looked at the camera. All right, it says RJ on it. God, what could that mean? Robert Downey Jr.? Really jacked? Rump Juicy? Hiro? Yeah, Hiro. I know. Well, he was also the other one that was always in the rec room. So we don't know. We don't know where Hiro went. We all showed up. So an hour ago, it was Hifumi, Hiro, Byakuya, Taka. There's two more. Toko. Why am I fucking counting on this? Toko. Who's the last? Oh my god. Let me just open the notepad. Let's get the notepad out. We might as well. We're going to need it later. We're going to have to mark down who fucking died, aren't we? Notepad. That's actually not... Let's find the corner there. All right. Let's see. Schitt's Creek reference. Camera.
No, I actually didn't mean to make it. My mom, like, I had a lot of people who've told me to watch that fucking show, honestly. I've watched a little bit of it. It is pretty funny. I heard it, like, fucking cleaned the fuck up at the Emmys or whatever it was. Okay. So, Kyoko, Aoi, Sakura, and myself were there. So, Celeste said she got attacked. Oh, that's the last person. Okay. Everyone else is okay. Culprit must be tall. Wait, Hifumi is 170 centimeters. Yeah. Could be on stilts, though. That's the thing. I'm wondering if it's like a cosplay thing. Like the same people who do like the big, big stuff. Huh?
No?
Well, you were definitely right about the strange part. Their face is totally covered. God damn, it was the Power Ranger. Is that a robot costume? As I said, where the fuck was that? I feel like that was mentioned before. A very strange and suspicious individual. So this weird robot guy dragged Hifumi away. Shit, maybe I'll check it out. Maybe, I don't know. And I took this right after being attacked. In other words, a full hour ago. I've never seen her pained expression, which is why if we don't hurry, it could become a serious problem.
See.
I believe I understand what happened. Well, no. There is much I don't understand, but I'm about to be like, fucking shed your goddamn light. The point is, someone dressed like that dragged Hifumi away. That's so sweet. And it happened over an hour ago.
Just a second.
This is bad. We have to hurry. Celeste, do you know where this mysterious man went?
Let's see.
When they left the rec room, they headed left, but then I was knocked the fuck unconscious. Just kidding.
See.
That's true. They were headed toward the stairs, leading down to the second floor. I mean, oh yeah. No, I think maybe I didn't say hero, but Kyoko is downstairs. Uh-oh. Then he must be down there, right? The second floor. That's where Kyoko was supposed to be. Huh, speaking of which, why isn't Kyoko here? Probably because she's... What's that fucking giant pink robot song? No. Take an intermission. Pink robot song. Yoshimi. I was thinking Yoshimi battles the pink robots. I don't know. Kyoko battles the fucking Power Ranger robots. the notepad. Fuck. It's fine. It wasn't covering too much up. Okay. Sorry. I didn't have time to go look for her. So sus, Kyoko.
This is bad.
Oh, shit. Not Otto. Okay. This is bad. If the strange man did head to the second floor, Kyoko might run into him. We have to hurry. Kyoko's in danger. As soon as the words out of my mouth, we all rushed out of the room and down to the second floor. Hey, you two. What's going on? What's all the fuss?
What?
Oh, nice. She's back. Yeah, you guys playing a game or
what
something? Does it freaking look like we're playing a game? Listen, have either of you seen Kyoko Hifumi or a big fucking robot? Rope. Nope. Sure haven't. Are they on this floor? We just got here ourselves. Where were you guys? I heard some kind of uproar, so I came running. They're called Zords. Jill is here. We came here together. No, she's stalking me. Anyway, can you guys help us look for them? Why? What happened? Megazords. Okay. All right. We're looking for a Megazord then. Why? What happened? There's no time now. We'll explain later.
Fine.
Well, fine. It sounds like something interesting is going on.
Okay.
Hifumi, Kyoko, if you can hear me, say something. Her voice echoed down the hall in vain.
Oh.
Did you hear something? Maybe.
Perhaps.
Byakuya, yes, sus. I think it came from the library. The library. Okay, let's go. We ran to the library as fast as our legs would carry us. Oh, is someone dead in the archives? I'm going to open the door to the library. Oh, bitch!
It hurts. It hurts.
There's no fucking way it becomes that. You're fucking lying to me. We found Hifumi seriously injured. Are you okay? I'm glad to see you're still alive. It's super bad though. Look at all the blood. Yeah, you know what? How did you get hurt? That guy smacked me on the ass. What guy? Robo Justice. Justice Amber 1. That's what I decided to call him just now.
What did you say?
What are you talking about? Robo Justice, you dumb bitch. Keep the fuck up. Good lord, you're simple. Hammer 2? Holy fuck. Is anyone gonna die? I wonder if anyone's gonna die. Is Kyoko dead? Of course she would be. Fucking classic Kyoko move. Wants us to think that we're... Alright, let's... I'm gonna look at the camera. If something happened here, this fan's camera must have caught it. Not that the mastermind would tell us if it did. Let's just look at everything. Let's look at all the clues. One of the monitors Monokuma appears on. Right now, it's just showing the school crest. Not much point in worrying about now. I'll try to just forget about it. I'm gonna say Kyoko, Hina, Sakura, Celeste, Hifumi, Hiro, Byakuya, Toko, Hiro, Kyoko, Sakura, Kyoko, Makoto, and Taka. Now's no time to be distracted by a bookshelf. All right. You know what? That's a good fucking point. The letter is still here. According to this letter, Hope Speak Academy. Yeah, it's the same shit. Alright, well, Jill?
No.
The serial killer. I don't know, maybe. Although, it looked like you're right, they were tall. That's a good point. I can know their heights. Let's talk to some people. Let's talk to Jill over here. Fat boy took a serious shellacking. Nice. Nice one. Good roast. I'm glad to see he is still alive. I'm seriously happy if Fumi's still alive, but Robo Justice? Yeah. This just keeps getting stranger.
What?
Robo Justice? You're fucking. Everyone's just. Alright, let's have Fumi. That guy was Robo Justice. This Robo Justice you're referring to is. Is this it?
What the hell am I looking at?
I had a fucking stroke reading that. This Robo Justice you were referring to is this. Is this. Oh, fuck. Okay. Is it not? There we go. Holy shit. What the hell am I looking at? This is the one that attacks Celeste and Hifumi. Isn't that right, Hifumi? Yeah, that's him. I'm sure of it. Robo Justice. Ah, RJ. So not Robbie Downey Jr. Robo Justice, huh? This just keeps getting stranger. Let's check this shit out. It's a hammer, just like the one Celeste was attacked with in the rec room, but this one is Justice Hammer 2. As far as I can tell, it's smaller, isn't it? On top of that, oh, never mind, it's bigger. All right, well, you ain't looking at a Kyoko here. Let's just put it that way. This one is actually a little bigger than the first one. Not that this size matters. He attacked me with that hammer. He bonked me around the head with the shit. By the time I edit this video, the bonk meme is long fucking gone. But I'm going to put it in here anyway. So fuck you. And if you're editing Jake on a Wednesday morning when this has to be uploaded and I just said that and you can't fulfill that promise, well, I love you. He attacked me with that hammer. He bonked me right on the head with it. Hammer that big, I'm surprised you're still okay. I'm not okay. Look at all this blood.
Hey!
Look at all this goop. Protein helps heal wounds, you know. Would you like some? I've never heard such a thing. Are you sure it isn't just you? I eat a cow whenever I get injured. And it's blood. Ah ha 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 ha. It's set eel. Poohoo, a robot of justice, huh? Now things are really starting to get exciting. What kind of special moves does it have? Can it fly? Can it combine? Yeah. Mickey D. You might be onto something.
No.
Taka hate Hifumi for the Elder Eagle.
What?
The Elder Eagle. Why is he here?
Are you okay with this?
Let's not concern ourselves with him. What we need to do now is get Hifumi to the nurse's office right away. Oh, wait, fuck. My brain turned off. Why is he here? Celeste is... She's pushing that narrative right now. I don't know.
Yeah.
You're right. Let's go. Thanks, everyone. Thanks, bitches. You moved her for me to the nurse's office on the first floor. So because... Take care of his injuries. That just seems too obvious. I gotta be real. It just seems too obvious, though. That was like Byakuya. So you mean Celeste... Celestisus. I've seen people write her name as Celestia. I think it was like Celestia. I had someone follow me, actually. It was like Celestia Ludenberg. My name is Celestia Ludenberg. Is that like a translation thing? Do they make it different in some of the translations? How you feeling, Hifumi? You want me to take a look at ya? I'm okay. I think it stopped bleeding.
I'm still kind of dizzy, though.
So then...
Perhaps you should rest here a while.
I don't trust this hoe.
I
trust
suppose.
This nasty hoe. I like Celeste, but I don't trust that bitch. Good idea.
Well, then...
The rest of us should get back to looking for that mystery
ass
ailant. Indeed, before another victim appears, the justice hammers seem to be increasing in size. First one, and now two.
So, in other words...
If there is a justice hammer three, we can only assume it is even bigger than the first two, if they combine. If you got hit with anything bigger than that, you'd be dead for sure. Tell us what happened to you, Hifumi. Well, I woke up early this morning and started looking for alter ego ahead of everyone else. I went to the third floor, and that's where the strange... I thought it said consumed man attacked me. I'm so sorry. I guess that makes... I mean, I believe that alibi for him being like, I want to start looking early. Because he's consumed by alter ego. That must be what I witnessed at around 7 this morning.
Wow.
After that, he dragged me to the library and whack, down came Ziemma. That must have been 30 or 40 minutes ago.
Hmm.
At around 7:30, in other words, we would have still been in the dining hall, which means Hina, Sakura, and I were together, and Kyoko was still with us. So we all have alibis. Alibis, as some would like to say. I was in the laundry room, doing my laundry.
Yes!
His black underwear is as black as the pitch black darkness of the blackest night. You know what? She really is a real one, Genocide Jill. Why do you know that? Isn't it obvious? Because I was peeking. That's sweet. Anyway, so that means Byakuya and Toka were together at the time, meaning they also have alibis. The only ones who don't have alibis for when Celeste and Hifumi were attacked are the only two we haven't seen yet, Hiro and Taka. That's it, right? Me fucking remembering everyone's names.
Very strange.
By the way, what happened to Kyoko? I haven't seen her anywhere. She was supposed to be She was supposed to be checking the second floor, but I didn't see her up there at all. Where could she have disappeared to? She disappeared, huh? What a strange woman.
So that's it.
She might be exactly as I suspected. Hold on! Kyoko was with us in the dining hall when Celeste and Hifumi were attacked, so... I'm not talking about who attacked them, you contemptuous little worm. Huh?
In other words...
I'm referring to what we talked about last night, who the mastermind spy might be. Are you saying Kyoko's working with the mastermind? That's not possible.
What?
Isn't it? This woman, who seems almost eager to handle dead bodies, hasn't even revealed her true identity.
Hey!
Save this discussion for later. Right now, we need to focus on finding the suspicious
okay.
individual. Yeah, if we don't hurry, there's only going to be more victims. That might be why Kyoko and Taka and Hiro haven't shown up yet. She's right. We have to do something about... Oh, my God. Jesus. I had a fucking twitch there. We have to do something about that mystery man first. Don't worry about me. I'll catch up with you guys after I rest for a bit. Understood. Take care of yourself.
Well, then.
Okay, let's head out. Hifumi, dead. So whoever that is running around, why are they wearing that weird costume? Don't bother looking for a reason. For reason from a deviant.
What to do?
So,
what to do?
What are we gonna do? Split up and look around. Let's look for clues, gang. Ultimate detective? That'd be so fucking funny. Our opponent is very dangerous. We don't know what they're capable of, even here.
What?
What's wrong? I saw shadow, something moving around at the top of the stairs.
Really?
Up on the second floor then. You bastard! You won't get away from me. We all shot towards the stairs. Bang, 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 bang! He must be around here somewhere. Let's split up and corner him.
Well.
But don't take any chances. As soon as you find him, call out and I'll come running. Okay, but what should we yell?
Just a second.
Anything, it doesn't matter.
So then?
Then is...
Ha!
Okay. Ha or do-ya or whatever you want. Just yell loud enough so we can hear you. Haha, do-ya, never heard such a reaction. Oh my God, Celeste, you're so fucking suspicious right now. Just hurry up and start looking, okay? Let's go. Hey, Mr. Robot, where are you hiding? If you don't come out, we're gonna decommission you. We spread out... Is that a RoboCop joke? We spread out in every direction to track down the costume suspect. But I saved my game first. Well, let's... You know what? I'm gonna go to the art room. I'm just gonna go off intuition and head to the fucking... Oh, it's the second floor. Pardon me. Can it actually show me? Does it show me where everyone went?
Okay, everyone's in the hall. I don't think it'd be in the library, because Alpha and Omega was in there. Let's go to classroom 2B. Let's go the farthest, the furthest we can. Reality isn't everything. I feel like I've heard that before. Don't see no shit. I'm gonna leave the area, dumb bitch. Might be one of those things where you check. Yeah, there we go. Celeste, I guess. That strange cry! That had to be Celeste. It came from the floor above. She's on the third floor. I sprinted up to the third floor. I yeeted myself through the ground. Over here, everyone. Everyone who heard the scream had come
just
running.
Just a second.
Celeste, what's wrong?
What?
That was a rather intense scream for someone like you. I saw him, the strange costume man. He ran off as soon as I screamed. I was blocking the stairs, so he headed further down to the hallway and disappeared. He must be down this hall. Come on, let's go. Ha ha. What is it now? Oh, look at that fucking yeet. That snot is coming out. Huh? Whoa, it's really true. But that doesn't matter right now. Is that Hifumi? Huh? What was that? That came from downstairs. It must have been Hifumi. He's in the nurse's office. This is bad. Come on, we have to go back. What about the suspect? We've gone to all this trouble to capture him, right? Then why don't we split into two groups?
It's all clear now.
I'll lead the hunting party. That seems much more interesting.
So then?
Very well then. Makoto and Hina, you come with me to the nurse's office. I will lead the capture of the suspicious individual to Toko, Sakura, and Byaku. Yeah, we gotta remember this. So Toko, TSB, and MCA. Well, it is not Celeste. I think... I don't know. Could be one of those things where it's just like, oh, I had an alibi. I wasn't there. Blah, 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 blah. But like, I don't know. I don't know, man.
So then...
We'll handle it. Just go take care of Haifumai. Okay, you guys be careful. Have a good day. With that, we split into two groups. With that, we split the party. Me, Celeste, and Hina all ran downstairs to the first floor.
Just a second.
He's in the nurse's office. Let's go. Let's go. We stormed to the nurse's office, and what greeted us was, oh, please don't be dead. A world of dripping crimson. Hifumi, that's so sad. Everything was covered in red, and in the center of all this red was Hifumi.
No!
Ah, yeah, what, man. It looks like something very bad happened. You don't fucking say, Ding Dong. I certainly was not. Really? Were you not expecting this? I was expecting this. Oh, Celeste was not expecting this. I did not imagine that Hifumi would be murdered. I was thinking someone should have stuck around with him. Murdered? You're not serious, are you? He's not really dead, is he? Dead body announcement. And as if on cue.
A body has been discovered.
Nice.
Do I have water? I do. I have water.
After a certain amount of time, which you may use however you like, the class trial will begin.
Oh, it's going to be a lot of keeping track who was on what fucking floor. So the entire time we didn't see Kyoko. Well, Kyoko went to the second floor. She never showed up. And then that was it. The last time we saw her was at the dining hall. We never saw Taka or Hina. Hiro. So I know it couldn't have been Hina. I don't know. I'm not sure. After a certain amount of time, which you may use however you like, the class trial will begin. What the? That was the body discovery announcement. The body discovery announcement? When three or more people discover a body after a murder, that's what plays. So three or more. Okay. And since we just heard it, that means... We don't know, man. We don't fucking know. It must mean Hifumi. Someone killed one of us. One of us. And look at that. When Celeste said that, she pointed to something. Something on the floor. something that had also been on the floor after the last two surprise attacks. Big Hammer 3. Justice Hammer. I want to look at Hifumi first. It can't really be, can it, that Hifumi is? Anyway, before I do anything, I have to confirm what I saw. Another hammer. I certainly do. I like it because I like these kind of games. I never kind of play games like this. I play a shooter or something where you don't honestly have to think too much. I like playing strategy games, but really just for like map painting, like just to like cheat and kind of do that kind of stuff. And this game is nice because it's if I have the strategy game, you have to be thinking about a lot of things while they're all happening at once. And you can't really pause and think it out in a lot of them. But this game, at least you can. You can kind of put the logic together.
As is possible.
Honestly, yeah, overthinking it sometimes fucks it up. And it's even bigger than the other two.
One strike from that. Just as I suspected, one strike from that and you are finished.
And the killer, there can be no doubt, the suspicious individual. Going by what Hifumi called him, the culprit must be Robo Justice. Whoever's hiding that costume is the one that killed Hifumi. But wait, you saw him on the third floor, right? Running back into the hall. So how did he end up at the nurse's office? You're not saying they like teleported or something, right? Are you okay with this? We can figure that part out later. Contradiction, what I said? No, forget about it. Right now we have to tell the others. You're right. No, so she fucking then. Ain't. She's like, anyway, the fucking side eye. She's like,
wanna head out?
Ouch. Oh, owie. Hina, snap out of it. Huh? Are you okay? Hina?
Sorry.
Sorry, I'm not sure I can move right now. I'm feeling kinda... This is a problem. We can't just leave Hina here alone. Okay, then. I'll go get everyone. You stay here with Hina.
Very well. I leave it to you, then.
Okay, I'll be back soon. She seemed a little bit, hesitant about that. I don't know. Celeste is kind of...
What does she have? Like, I bet her big secret is, like, she has, like, debts to pay off or something. It's exactly $10 million.
Okay, I'll be back soon. I tried to sound confident and upbeat, but I still hadn't stopped trembling from what I'd just been through. I tried to put a spin of positivity on that. Everyone else is starting the third floor. I have to hurry. Everyone's dead. This is where everyone was chasing after this individual. Where was he headed? Oh my god, burp soon, man. Celeste, what's wrong? That was a rather intense scream for someone like you. I saw him, the strange costume man. He ran off as soon as I screamed. I was blocking the stairs, so he headed further down to the hallway and disappeared. He ran off, going further down the hallway, way into the back of the hallway. Alright, let's... No, not the map. I want you so bad. Could go in the art room. Let's check out the art room. It'll say if that's not correct. Because I'm guessing that's where those hammers are from. Nope. Nothing too sus. Oh, is that me? The man with the largest brain? There are wood mounts hanging on the wall. If I had to guess, I'd say they use them for making sculptures. But some of them are missing, would you not say? Leave the repository. I don't know, maybe you didn't think you could finish her right away. It's like, yeah, Celeste is very suspicious. I just don't know who, I don't know. Into the air purifier room? The time machine room? The back door's open. As far as I could tell, there's nobody here, but still, I feel some kind of presence. Yeah, I'm sure I can feel someone's presence. This presence. Is it coming from over there in the back? Walk in, game over. Come play Danganronpa 2. I leapt through the doorway. When I did, I found...
Holy fuck, dude. Oh, fuck, man. Hold on. can't fucking handle it. Ugh, if it's Hero, the only person that'd be okay with dying is honestly Hero, because they don't have any attachment to Hero. I'm actually more attached to Byakuya than I am to Hero. I don't know how to explain it. I don't know why. Alright. Yeah. Yeah, I wonder. I wonder. That's what I'm thinking. The second nightmare of the day was waiting there to greet me. Oh, man. There, in a pool of his own blood, was Taka, dead. Danganronpa. I think, fuck me and my fat ass. Fumi's body discovered in the nurse's office. Taka's body discovered in the equipment room. So, question though, one of them might still be alive. It's either both of them are dead, and only two people have seen Taka's corpse, which seems odd because there's no one else up on this floor, or the dead body announcement was only for one of them. I was witness to two nightmares, one right after another. No, they weren't nightmares. This is harsh reality. This is fart reality, if you know what I mean. The true nightmare is this reality, the reality I have to face every day. But still. Why is this happening? Oh, okay, never mind. Pyaki was like, what a shame. What a shame. Sakura's like, what a shame. Oh, look at that fatty over there. All right, we got a lot to look at. Lots and lots and lots. We got a skateboard over there. Is that? Let's talk to Sucky Sakura. Nope, got nothing to say. There's been no dead body announcement. Oh, could have been Toko when she fainted. Let's check on her. Toko! Don't tell me. Toko too? No, it can't be, because only two people. Relax, she just passed out when she saw the blood. The blood? Oh, that's right. When Toko is, Toko, she has a fear of blood, huh? We tried everything to get her to wake up, but no luck. Just leave her be for now. It's like he said, I should just leave her alone for now. Okay. I don't have time to look at a stinking monitor. Tarp is there for a reason. It's just a stupid tarp. I can't be bothered with a tarp right now. A skateboard. A dolly. No, I can't afford to waste time on this. There's big old hammer number three. Another hammer. Now it's just his hammer. Four. Oh, because Hifumi was killed with three. That's right. That's even bigger than before. Is that suspicious individual responsible for killing Taka too?
However.
But why is it Justice Hammer 4?
Huh? What do you mean? Celeste was attacked with Justice Hammer 1, then Tafumi was hit with Justice Hammer 2, but this time it was Justice Hammer 4. What happened to number 3?
Oh, BT Dubs? Yeah, Hifumi fucking ate shit.
What?
Nani is the matter. Well, when you mentioned Justice Hammer 3, you just reminded me. Out with it. Do you know something? Actually, Taka's not the only one that's been killed. Hifumi's dead too.
What?
Hifumi's been killed? Yeah.
I see.
Which is why you came to get us. Then we'd better go check it out. Of course, come on. Oh, I didn't check out Taka's body. So Sakura, Byakuya, and I rush out of the physics lab. Oh my god, Toko is there alone! She's gonna get her fucking throat slit. I think there can only be two killings total. In a killing, I don't know if they call it a killing game. Okay. But as soon as we were out of the physics lab. I told you to wait downstairs! What are you doing? Celeste, aren't you supposed to be waiting in the nurse's office? Something has come up.
What the fuck is going on?
Hifumi is dead. Yeah, I heard. Hifumi is dead, right? Well, that is not all.
It is gone. Huh, what's gone? It has disappeared. Disappeared. Fumi's body has disappeared. Hafumer the Zoomer, he's still alive. What?
What are you talking about?
It disappeared. It's disappeared. Don't be ridiculous.
Come on.
Are you serious?
What?
Nani, the heck is happening here? Everyone, back to the nurse's office. Fuck, man. Shit, good exercise. I practically leapt down the stairs, nearly losing my balance. I reached the nurse's office, completely out of breath. Shit, Hafumer the Zoomer. Doomy Hafumi. I couldn't believe my eyes. Hafumi's body was there just a few minutes earlier. But it wasn't his body, was it? It just disappeared. Aoi Asahina. Me and Celeste. Went to the bathroom? Alright. That's weird. But we were only gone for like a minute. And then when we got back.
Indeed.
This must be the work of the culprit. They must have come and carried the body away. They must really be enjoying this. Enjoying the sight of us standing around, frightened and confused. We're all going to die here. We're going to die just like those guys died.
What did you say?
I don't believe this. I don't believe a body would just disappear. Why? First, there were two murders, and now one of the bodies has been taken. They haven't been taken. The one of them's alive. This is unnatural. Huh? Hold on. What do you mean two murders? Oh, yeah, that's right. Taka, yeah, he's dead. I mean, Mondo, I guess, died again as well, if you believe in that stuff. What do you mean two murders? Okay. So up until this point, I don't know where we left off, but I'll kind of go pretty much a robot has been running. We saw someone. Oh, boy, 797. Thank you. I appreciate the follow. Thank you very much. Oh, God, what the fuck happened? I think. Oh, it is. Oh, I see. Thank you. I really appreciate it. Okay. So you saw Taka die. And then pretty much it was three people discovered him. It was Sakura, Byakuya, and Toko. And Toko had fainted, so we left her up there, and we actually came down here because I was coming to get them to tell them that Hafumi had been killed. But the thing is we only got one dead body announcement, and it said a dead body has been... And then, it said a body has been discovered. So now... I'm guessing that Hafumi is still alive and he got up and walked away because Hina and Celeste went to the washroom together. They went to the washroom together. And so now we're all talking about that and we're just catching everyone up. Taka's been killed. We found him in the equipment room.
No way!
It can't be. Taka 2? No, Taka 1. It can't be. It can't be.
No!
Hina!
Hina, chill the fuck out. I don't think he cared. I think he got up. I don't think he's dead. We're all gonna die. All of us are gonna kill all of us. Then who might the next target be? Toko? Yeah, that's pretty beefy. Huh?
What?
I completely forgot. She's still unconscious in the equipment room. You left her in the scene of the crime? We didn't have a choice. Smug little smile. He's like, shit, alright. She passed out and she refused to wake up. She didn't take the initiative to wake up.
Huh?
So she is still unconscious.
Damn.
Wait, so you knew she was still up there and said nothing? Pourquoi? That annoying little insect that clings to me wherever I go. We'd be better off without her.
Bastard!
Calm down. You forgot about her, didn't you? You have no right to blame me. You have no right to blame me. Everyone stop fighting. Right now we need to hurry back. I can't take this anymore. I don't want anyone else to die.
Damn.
Byakuya. Byakuya, if something happened to Toko, I'll never forgive you. Well, let's run. Toko, we shot out of the nurse's office and bolted up the stairs, heading back to the third floor. We ran back to the equipment room at full speed. When we got there... Oh, she's fine. Where dat corpse be, though? Where dat corpse be? Thank God you're okay. But right away I noticed there was something very different here. Yeah, bish. We haven't seen Kyoko or Hina.
But I mean, like, that's like, that could be like, well, it's got to be one of them, but it can't be. I mean, like, well, it can be. Never mind. It was gone. Taka's body, which should have been right there, had disappeared. Well, fuck my ass. This can't be happening. But it do, Byakuya. But it do. Now, I gotta go pee, and we are at 1 hour and 5 minutes on the recording. I'm just gonna be continue streaming this, but for this episode, I'm gonna call it here on YouTube. So, yeah, if you are enjoying this, I'm glad that you're enjoying this. Thank you for watching so far into this. I'm having a really good time. I really like this game a lot. Yeah, so I hope you have a good rest of your fucking day, I guess. We're gonna find out what happened to... I'm not sure who did it yet. I've got some sus. I mean, like Hina and Kyoko are kind of a thing. I don't know. They're the only ones that we haven't seen. That's the thing. We haven't seen them, but we haven't looked at. I don't know if we've looked in every room. These bodies are disappearing. So my theory about Hifumi and Taka not being dead might not be correct, because we only got one dead body announced, but I'm not sure how that works when there's two corpses. But we just know that no more people can die, because there is that, because what's his name, Monokuma, mentioned that. But if Taka carry Hifumi, I think Hifumi is the culprit. I think Taka could carry Hifumi. I think he'd be strong enough. But either way, I will see you in the next YouTube video. So you have a good rest of your day. Fare fucking well.